Welcome students, welcome to the new session of Laplace transform. So as we have been discussing the various properties of the Laplace transform, and we have discussed about the differential of the function and we have derived its Laplace transform and many more properties. So in this session we shall be discussing about how to calculate the Laplace transform of the integral of a function. So we know that if our L of f t is equal to f of s, so if our L of f t is f of s, then the Laplace of the integral of the function, that is Laplace of integral 0 to t, where the limits of the integrals are 0 and t, so the Laplace of the integral 0 to t f t dt is given by 1 by s f of s. So we shall be discussing how to calculate the Laplace transform of the integral of the function. So this is the formula. So let's derive, let's see, look at the proof of this function. So if supposingly we have to derive the Laplace of the integral of the function, so let that integral of the function be represented by a new function, that is psi t. So psi t is taken to be the integral f t dt, where the limits of the integrals are from 0 to t. And when we substitute, you can see here, we have taken psi 0 equal to 0, means that here what it is, it means that it is the value of psi t at t equal to 0. So when our t value is equal to 0, so psi 0 is 0. So how it is there? Because we know we have to put the value of t equal to 0. So when we put the value of t equal to 0, so in this integral, the upper limit of t of the function, this t value will be equal to 0. So when the upper limit of the integral is 0, and we can see that the lower limit and upper limit both are 0, then in that case, what happens when the both the limits, upper and lower limits, are 0, then our function is equal to 0. So this implies that our psi 0 is 0. And we differentiate our function, then on differentiation, what happens if we differentiate, we take the differentiation, that is psi dash t, then on differentiation d by dt of our integral of the function. So what will happen, that the differentiation and the integral will cancel out, and what will be left out, it will be left out with the function itself. So that is why we have written that your psi dash t is equal to f t. So you can see here that our function psi t is 0 to t f t dt, where the limits are from 0 to t, and when we put the value of t equal to 0, therefore our psi 0 is equal to 0. And if we take the derivative of the function of the psi function, then your derivative of psi t is, that is psi dash t, is equal to the function itself, that is f t. So now we take the Laplace of the derivative of the function. So we are taking the Laplace of the psi dash t. We know that the first order derivative, if we carry out the Laplace on the first order derivative, then the formula for that is s Laplace of psi t minus of psi 0. So we shall be substituting the value. So we know that this psi dash t is f t. So we substitute the value of psi dash t. So it comes out to be Laplace of f of t. And this psi t, we can substitute the value of psi t from this equation, because we know that psi t is 0 to t f t dt integral. So we have substituted the value of psi t as 0 to t integral f t dt. And we know that psi 0 is 0. So we have substituted the value of psi 0 as 0. So making all these substitutions, what we can write, we know that Laplace of f t is nothing but f of s. You can see it here, that Laplace of f t is f of s. So we have written that Laplace f t is f of s, and we are writing s times Laplace of 0 to t f t dt. Minus 0 is again the same, that is s Laplace of 0 to t f t dt. So we get your fs is equal to s into l Laplace of 0 to t f t dt. So this s is taken on the other side, so we can write that the Laplace of the integral of the function where the limits are from 0 to t is equal to 1 by s fs. Or this can also be written for the inverse Laplace transform. So we are writing the expression as that the integral of the function f t dt can be written as Laplace inverse of 1 by s of fs. So this, in this way, we can calculate the Laplace transform of the integral of the function. So we have to remember, whenever we take the Laplace of the integral of the function, the limits should be from 0 to t, and then we calculate the Laplace of the function and divide that function, divide our Laplace transform by s. So we get the resultant of the integral of the function. So the Laplace of the integral of the function is simple, that is the f of s divided by s. And from this formula, we can also deduce that the integral of the function is equivalent to the Laplace inverse of fs by s. So we have derived our formula for the calculation of the Laplace transform of the integral of our function. So moving to the next property, we are now going to calculate the Laplace transform of a function which is multiplied by t, and it could also be multiplied with any power of t. We have that our Laplace of f of t is written as fs. So the Laplace of t raised to power n times the function f of t will be given by minus 1 raised to power n nth derivative with respect to s of f of s. So whatever is the power of t, you can see here, whatever is the power of t, so minus 1 is multiplied that number of times, and the order of the differentiation is the same as the power of t. So we have to differentiate our f of s with respect to s, and the differentiation, the order of differentiation is same as the power of t is being multiplied by f of t. So we have the formula that Laplace of t to the power n ft is minus 1 raised to power n nth derivative with respect to s of f of s. So this is the formula for the Laplace transform of t of ft. So now we try to see the proof. So the proof is, if L of ft is f of s, then by the basic definition of our Laplace transform, this is written as 0 to infinity integral e to the power minus st ft. We are differentiating our first equation a with respect to s, so d by ds of f of s. So we have written d by ds and substituted the value of f of s, which is the basic definition. Now we can interchange our integral and differentiation. Now you can see here that there are two terms inside the integral. First term is e to the power minus st, and second term is f of t. So here two variables are involved. One variable is this s, and the second variable is this t value. So when we are interchanging the integral and differentiation, so we cannot directly replace our total derivative with the integral. So that is why we have taken the partial differentiation with respect to s and not the total differential, because there are two variables. One is s and the second is t, as e to the power minus st consists of two variables, s and t, where the function f of t is function of just one variable. So that is why the partial differentiation is involved in spite of the total differentiation. So we are taking the differentiation inside the integral. So the total differentiation is replaced by the partial differential with respect to s. And since e to the power minus st is only consisting of s term, so the differentiation will be carried on only the s exponential part and not on the function value. So when we carry out the differentiation on e to the power minus st, so the t value will be considered as constant and the differentiation is carried out only on the s part. So it comes out to be minus t times e to the power minus st ft into dt. So now we can write this expression as, we can rearrange the terms and we can write this expression as e to the power minus st, and we have clubbed minus t with our ft function. So this can be written as we can see here, the basic definition was e to the power minus st ft dt. So whatever is the ft here, that ft is appearing in the basic definition. So this minus sign is taken out. So instead of now writing as Laplace of ft, we are now writing at Laplace of t times ft, because the ft is now in the basic definition, ft is now clubbed to be as tft. So this is the basic definition for the Laplace of t times ft. So you can see here that this minus sign can be taken out, and what it will come, that Laplace of t of ft is minus 1 raised to power 1, because 1 negative sign is coming and 2 derivative with respect to s of f of s. Similarly, if we carry out again the differentiation of f of s, that is the second order differentiation, so the same steps will be repeated again. So here again a negative sign will appear, and again we have to replace this by partial differentiation. So what happens now? So there will be minus 1 raised to power of 2. So there will be minus 1 raised to power 2, and the partial derivative will be now replaced by double partial differentiation. So it would be coming out to be minus 1 raised to power square d square by ds square of f of s. So the Laplace of t square ft will be minus 1 whole square d square, that is the double differentiation with respect to s of f of s. Similarly, if we work on these same parallel lines, we go on differentiating our f of s, we land up with this general equation, that Laplace of n power of t times ft will be nothing but minus 1 raised to power n, nth order of differentiation with respect to s of f of s. So this is the general formula for calculating the Laplace transform of t times ft, or t to the power n times of ft. So I hope that you have understood how to calculate the Laplace transform of t raised to power n of ft. So the next property we are going to discuss is to calculate the Laplace transform of ft divided by t. So the function is now divided by a polynomial t, and we have to calculate the Laplace transform of such a function. So if we have the Laplace of f of t is equal to f of s, then the Laplace of ft divided by t is given by the integral of fs ds, and the limits are from s to infinity. The lower limit is s and the upper limit is infinity. So let's see how it works and what is the proof of the Laplace of a function divided by t. So we start with the basic definition. So let f of s is equal to 0 to infinity e to the power minus st ft dt. Now we integrate the expression with respect to s. Now why did this need came to integrate the expression? Because we can see on the left hand side of the above theorem that f of s is being integrated. You can see here that f of s is being integrated with respect to s. So we are integrating our basic definition of the Laplace transform with respect to s. So integral s to infinity fs ds is equivalent to s to infinity integral, and inside we have integral 0 to infinity to the power minus st ft dt ds cos the integral. So now we have two integrals. One integral is over t and the other integral is over s. So if we integrate with respect to what we have for this integral over s st ds, so we have integral s to infinity to the power minus st ds, because ft is a function which is over t variable. So this ft has come out of this integral where we are integrating first over s. So we integrate e to the power minus st with respect to s. So we get e to the power minus st by minus t, and the limits are from s to infinity. So putting the limits, we get e to the power minus infinity t minus e to the power minus st, and minus t is in the denominator. And we know that anything raised to power of, where we have infinity in the power, so, and there is a negative sign, so this value is equivalent to zero. So we have zero minus of e to the power minus st. And we have a negative sign here also in the denominator with t. So we get minus minus plus sign. So we get e to the power minus st ft dt. And for this, we can, if we club this ft by t, we can say that this is nothing but the Laplace transform of ft by t. We know that the Laplace transform is given by e to the power minus st ft dt. So now instead of ft, what we are having the function ft by t. So this can be written as Laplace of ft by t. So therefore, we have proved our relativity is s to infinity fs of ds. So I hope that you have understood the expression that Laplace of ft, the function divided by t, is equal to the integral of fs, where the integral is carried over the s variable and the limits are from s to infinity. So if we look at the summary, we can say that the Laplace transform of the derivative of order n is given by the formula that Laplace of nth derivative of the t is given to be Sn Laplace of function ft minus s raised to power n minus 1 function at the t value equivalent to 0 minus Sn raised to power minus 2 Sn minus 2 first order derivative for the t at equivalent to 0 minus s raised to power n minus 3 second order derivative for t equivalent to 0 and so on till Fn minus 1 at t equal to 0. Similarly, the Laplace transform of the integral of the function is given by Laplace 0 to t integral ft dt is fs by s. And Laplace transform of the t polynomial, if it has a power of nth times, so t raised to power n ft will be given by minus 1 raised to power n d by ds. N means the nth derivative with respect to s of f of s. And if we have a function f of t which is divided by t, then the Laplace transform of ft by t is nothing but integral of fs with respect to s from the limits s to infinity. So let's have a look at one of the problem. Here we have taken a function which is t square e to the power 2t sine 9t, and we have to take the Laplace of such a function. So since the function is t square e to the power 2t sine 9t, first of all, we can say, let us find the Laplace of sine 9t. So the Laplace of sine at is a upon a square plus a square. So a is 9. So it is 9 upon a square plus 9 square, which is 9 upon a square plus 81. Then if we have the function Laplace of e to the power 2t sine 9t, then we can apply the first shifting theorem, and whatever was there in s, s is now shifted by s minus a. So a is what? A is this 2 term, which is in the exponential e to the power 2t. So s gets shifted by s minus 2. So now the Laplace of e to the power 2t sine 90 is 9 upon s minus 2 ka whole square plus 81. And now if we consider the Laplace of t e to the power 2t sine 90, this means that this was the our whole function ft, and t is getting multiplied by the function. So we have already discussed here itself that when t is multiplied by the function, we take the derivative of f of s. So f of s is calculated for e to the power 2t sine 90. So the answer of f of s is this quantity, that is 9 upon s minus 2 ka whole square plus 81. And here t to the power 1 is getting multiplied. So we can take the first order derivative with respect to s, and there is a multiplication by minus 1. So we take the first order derivative with respect to s of f of s of e to the power 2t sine 90. So we get here 9 comes out, we get minus 9. And we take the first order derivative, we get minus 1, 2 into s minus 2, because s minus 2 ka whole square gets differentiated to form 1 minus 1 upon s minus 2 ka whole square plus 81, and again s minus 2 ka whole square is differentiated to form, give the result as 2 into s minus of 2. So with the calculations we get it is 18 times s minus 2 upon s minus 2 ka whole square plus 81 ka whole square. So this is the Laplace of t e to the power 2t sine 90. Now we want to calculate Laplace of t square e to the power 2t sine 90. So this can be represented as t into t e to the power 2t sine 90. So now we have calculated the Laplace transform of this function. So now again we multiply it by t, so which is again equivalent to minus 1 d by ds of 18 s minus 2 upon s minus 2 ka whole square plus 81 ka whole square. Because we know that this bracket term is the same quantity that we have got here. So we have substituted the value, we get minus 1 d by ds 18 s minus 2 upon s minus 2 ka whole square plus 81 ka whole square. So again differentiating, we get this formula, we get this result, and upon simplification we get the following part, that is 54 s square plus 4 minus 4 s minus 1458 upon s minus 2 ka whole square plus 81 ka whole cube. This is simple u by v formula, or you can expand it according to the chain rule of the differentiation u into v. You can use either of the two methods to solve the equation or the differentiation. So you land up to the result of 54 s square plus 4 minus 4 s minus of 1458 divided by s minus 2 ka whole square plus 81 ka whole cube. So this is one of the method of solving this problem. Another method is that you could have directly substituted for Laplace of t square e ki power 2t. So if you had taken this t square here itself, then it would have been here. It is minus 1 ka whole square d square by ds ka whole square upon this term. So here directly you could have taken the double differentiation, and there was a square of minus 1 term. So again, you would have got the same result. So there are many ways of solving the problem. You can do in any of the way. It is not necessary that you solve e to the power 2t sine 90. You could have even solved for like this. You could have solved for e to the power 2t t square 90. First you solve the Laplace of 90. So Laplace of 90 is, you know that it is 9 upon s square by 81. So you know this, for this you know the f of s. So you could have calculated first the Laplace of t square sine 90. So it would have been minus 1 ka whole square d square by ds square of 9 upon s square plus 81. So you could have solved the double differentiation for this term, and then you could have applied the first shifting theorem. So it is upon the user's choice that according what rule he wants to proceed in his solving the questions, whether he want to apply his first shifting theorem or he want to apply the t function first. So it depends upon his choice. So it can be performed in either of the way. So I hope that you are able to understand the problem, how the problem is being solved. So in this way, you can solve this problem. Now let us see one more problem, that the function ft is divided by t. So we have to now calculate the Laplace of e to the power at minus cos of bt by t. So we have Laplace of e to the power at minus cos pt. We first calculate the Laplace of this function. So we know that Laplace of e to the power at is 1 upon s minus a, and Laplace of cos bt is s upon s square plus b square. So we have applied the linearity property, where there is a, if two functions are getting added, so the Laplace are individually applied on individual functions. So Laplace, first the Laplace in carried on upon exponential at, so it comes the formula of 1 upon s minus a, and for Laplace of cos pt, it comes out to be s upon s square plus b square. So we have to now solve the Laplace of e to the power at minus cos bt. So we know that when the function is divided by t, so the Laplace is calculated by the formula that it is integral f of s, with the integral is over the s variable and the limits are from s to infinity. So the above result that we have got, that is our f of s. So we substitute this equation for f of s. So we get integral s to infinity 1 upon s minus a minus of s upon s square plus b square ds. So we have to integrate the expression. So our calculation of Laplace of ft by t just involves the first, the fs to be calculated, and then integral of the fs. So now this is simple integration which has to be solved. So it can also be separated as this. So there would be two integrals. One is for s minus a and second is for s upon s square plus b square. So now two individual integrals are being solved. So we get, for the first integral for s minus a, we get it is equal to log of s minus a, because we know that integral 1 by x dx is log x. So it is log of s minus a, and this term is, by substituting, let put this is equal to y. If we put this is equal to y, then we get 2s ds is equal to dy. So this is nothing but dy by 2. So we get the expression something like that, that it is equivalent to dy by 2y. So again we have a y function in the denominator, so it is again log y. So we get half log of, if we back substitute the value of y, we get log of s square plus b square. So we get the function as log of s minus a minus half log of s square plus b square, and the limits are from s to infinity. So now the question is just to insert the limits. So we get, we solve it, we get 2 log s minus a minus log of s square plus b square by 2. From this 2 log s minus a, the 2 is to taken to the power of s minus a. So you get log s minus a ka whole square minus log of s square plus b square. Now this is log m minus log n, which is log m upon n. So it is written as half log s minus a ka whole square upon s square plus b square. And the limits are from s to infinity. Now again we are doing that, we are taking the s common outside. So we get log of 1 by s ka whole square, 1 by s square, 1 minus a by s ka whole square upon 1 minus s ka whole, 1 by s square into 1 plus 1 by b square by s square. So this 1 by s square, 1 by s square cancels. You can also take s also common, and either way you take it. So you get this s square gets cancelled and you substitute the limits s to infinity. So we get 1 minus a by infinity ka whole square upon 1 plus b square by infinity minus log of 1 minus a by s ka whole square upon 1 plus b square by s square. So you get that this equation is equivalent to log 1 because a upon infinity is 0. So 1 minus 0 is 1, and similarly 1 plus b by infinity is again 0, so 1 plus 0 is 1. So you get log 1 minus log of 1 minus a by s ka whole square upon 1 plus b square. The value as minus half log 1 minus a by s ka whole square upon 1 plus b square by s square, which can also be written as interchanging m and n, we get half log 1 plus b square by s square upon 1 minus a by s ka whole square. So there must be a query in your mind that why did we not substitute the value of infinity directly? Why did we make all these calculations? So we made these calculations because if we had directly substituted infinity value in this equation, then what happened? Then if you had put the infinity value, then for s is equal to infinity. So if you had put here s is equal to infinity, so it would have taken the formula or would have come out to be log infinity. Here also we had log infinity, and here also when we substitute s is equal to infinity, so log infinity is not defined. So the answer would have been come out to be not defined function. So in that case, what we had to do, we had to take the s, we had to calculate, do the calculations in such a way that the s has to be taken in the denominator. So that was the need, that we took out the s common. So here s was taken out common from both the numerator and the denominator, so that the s is coming in the denominator of the log function. So such that when we put infinity value here, so we come out with zero value, because any number upon infinity is always zero. So that we have a defined function result and not an undefined value. So that was the reason for our calculations, that we had taken the s common and not substituted infinity directly into the result. So I hope that you must have understood how to solve the Laplace of the function where the function is being divided by a t function.